Quality drafting is becoming as rare as hen's teeth, and one of the reasons why quality has slipped is line weights in drafting aren't followed or done as well as they should be. Now, in a CAD system, colors most commonly used are used to represent line weights. You don't have to work that way, of course, there's other ways, but it's still a very popular way of working because it works really well. Now, selecting different colors is just like picking up pens with varying line thickness. And we can use these colors, we can tie them into layers and control visibility of the drawing components in CAD systems. Now, a lot of the colors in CAD came about because of pens that we used before. So old school drafters might remember these pens. I've got a set of these Faber-Castell ones, a few more options, but the bands had line thicknesses on it. So that brown one was 0.5 thick, the yellow one was 0.35, and in this one, the red brown was 0.18. And that's one thing you did notice between drawing sets, drafting pen sets. Some of the red and the brown were different thicknesses. And the blue too, the blue and the cyan, sometimes that was cyan. Sometimes it was blue, but the white and the yellow are pretty much the same everywhere. So in our CAD system, I can say that there is no really wrong or right CAD system, but there are definitely some of the more prevalent than others. Drafting, you see, managed to work very well for centuries without CAD. So it's hardly surprising that many of our CAD systems follow well-established manual drafting systems. So many offices adopted the ISO/DIN line weight coloring coding system, and you've commonly seen that on those bands of drafting pens. So changes to this system have in the main come about as a result of preferences for light and dark screen background within CAD. So naturally, yellow here works really well on a black background. Now if I change the background, and here's a power tip for you. So if I type in config or options in AutoCAD, I can go to display. Actually, I want to change that to dark, that's good. But in here, colors, you've got 2D model space and uniform background. I can change that to white, and you can see it works like that. So you wouldn't use yellow here because that's horrible on a white background. Now in Revit, when I use Revit, I have a white background and I don't use colors at all. I only have black. And so I recommend if you're using a white background, don't use colors at all. Use object by line weight, not color by line weight. That works as well. So let's switch back now to my preferred AutoCAD way of working, which is the black background. And talk a bit more about the ISO DIN and color system. So first of all, let's look at the colors and the color index in AutoCAD. So if you type in the color command, you'll get three tabs. There's the index color, and there's 256 colors from there. Now I primarily work only from that palette, in particular only these ones here, just these ones, these nine. Now I do use true colors, RGBs. That's only when I want to trick AutoCAD into printing color for me, and I've got an example of that in this drawing. And there's color books here with a whole range of different options, so you can actually, while AutoCAD in my opinion is one of the best vector drafting tools out there, you can do some other tricks in it as well since they've added those things. So having a swizz at the ISO/DIN line weight color coding system, this is the standard, and you can see on this drawing, I'm pretty close to it. So I've got white on the text there, that is 0.25. The yellow is 0.35. I don't have any red and brown. I do have blue, that's 0.7. Oh, sorry, I do have red, and that is 0.5 for the piers there. And the blue here's for bearers. I hardly ever use green. And I also have another color, that's color 9, which is shaded. So let's have a look at that. If I swizz over to my paper space, which is my title block only in there, and do a plot preview of that. So I'll just go plot, just make sure it's set up. Yep, PDF, A3, cobblestone. So I'll just have it show you the pens there. So you can go to the CTP file. It's my preferred way of doing it. It works well. Why change it? Now, these are the ones I use, the main ones, okay? They're only in the first nine and pretty much can do all sorts of drafting in that. So red, I use a lot. It's 0.5 thickness. You can control it there. Color black, of course, as the printout. Now, yellow, 0.35. Do use that sometimes. Black. Green, hardly ever use it. One. That's cyan, 0.35, never use it, but you could. Blue I use all the time, especially for boundaries and bearers, 0.7. Black, magenta, 0.5, so slight variation on the ISO there, I think. The white, black, 0.25, use that one all the time, especially for text. Now, color 8 I use all the time. This is my ultra thin one, 0.15 or 0.18. Use that for dimensions and any fine lines. And lastly, 9, which is my special one, screening at 40%. And I'll give you a preview of that, what that's about. So what this drawing is a structural framing plan, a ground floor plan. And I've got the architectural plan there in light on color 9, so it's shaded, so it just doesn't stick out as much. And then the thick lines here are the bearers, that's on that blue line. And I only other thing that I've done that's different, so everything's printing out white and black, is that I've put this ag drain on a true color, so it comes out as prints out as color, so it makes that stand out. So color, your choice, but have a good CAD standard and a lot easier to draft with, and pay attention to your line work. The key takeaway here is every line must mean something in CAD drafting.